to see how will that little thing work on 4 by 4 meters.
Yes.
When you extend
yes.
the small beautiful thing to 4 meters, suddenly it becomes
right.
quite empty.
So you're saying this is 1 to 2? This is...
Not necessarily. I didn't say anything.
I was told the four, exactly.
I was told up to 4 by 4. We were shown the thing. Okay, so I thought the bigger I make it, the better. Century and the other century, it's something bold, brave, new. As the girl said, I said in the text, we want something exciting. We want, I see that when I think of college soaring into the future, soaring into the future immediately gave me the thing about the glass and the blades there and all these things. Then I thought about bigger pieces of glass, but then I gave it up because the glass overall would look maybe attractive, but I would have lost the texture, possibility of texture, diversity of material, colors, etc. Plus, I would have been in danger to have it look like one of the industrial commercial decorations in the lobbies of corporations in Sydney. They look very attractive, but it's not really what we are here about. I made first, I made the thing about 4 or 6 panels, and they were a little bit kind of boring in a sense of that they were intercalating and overlapping and all this superimposing. But then I said they're a little bit squarish, rectangularish. What about the bird-like shape? Because this feather-like thing led me to a thought of a bird, and I thought, because it was mentioned as well at the meeting, the dove of peace, and I thought of a sweet bird of youth. So now I said, oh, but just restrain yourself. If it looks too much like a bird, we'll finish up with a gigantic bird. This story is not about birds. So I wanted to give it a hint, with nice shapes, bird-like thing, but not excessive, as much as I could, so control myself there. So that's how finally I decided about the 4 panels. Those actually 6 were still in the game. They were supposed to be spaced like this, one here, and one was supposed to be like there. But then I cleared it because I realized it's just too complex, too busy, too fragmented, yes. So then I said, okay, let's go for all these things that we can depict. We had the past, the present, and the future. That was the important thing. So I first tried to separate them in different panels, like each one to each, but then it didn't work. It just didn't work. So I said, but the past to myself, the past, the present, and the future are interlinked anyway.
Yes.
They kind of can't be separated just like this. Then I said, let's go for North Sydney as well, depiction of North Sydney, not only the school, because it's the context and the environment. And I saw, as I said at the end of the text, this project is a bit delicate to put it in words. Yes, the Monte Sant'Angelo project, of course, by all means. But I saw it a little bit more like, as well, Sydney, this part of Sydney as well, and hopefully a bit more than that still. So, I was a very drawn person always to the skyscrapers and the seascapes. So I took photocopies of skyscrapers in North Sydney, and then it tried in different techniques. It didn't work. One day I changed it around, like this is how there's one building, how you see one building, another building, another building, in North Sydney. So I just changed it around and decided to put a slant textured glass on top. I took a sample of glass, put it against my own thing and realized it would be a good idea. You have to have the opera house, you have to have the bridge, all these kind of things that are symbolical already now. Took me a long time about these things. I wanted to make them in all sorts of ways. Mosaic glass and the mirrors as well. Even try that. Spraying silhouettes, all these things. That's all somehow didn't work. From the bird's eye view, if possible, it's more dynamic. Because also the girl said, and I saw this project either dynamic and exciting or just better leave it. Then I thought about the unifying factor or a little kind of element that would be spread around throughout the panels. So So we mentioned innovation, communication, technology. Computers are definitely the thing for this century and for the future. So I dismantled the old computers, painted them, and kind of played with these things as well. Then showed these things as well. I made kind of dozens of artworks like that. It took a long time just experimenting with these things. That texture and diversity is not here only for the artistic reasons that we would like more of a texture. It was mentioned as well, the cultural, the multicultural, ethnic diversity and versatility of the college. So, and also the colors that Gels mentioned. When you think of a college, which colors come to mind? Oh, it was gold, it was purple, it was blue, it was this, it was the other. So I tried to combine it with these keyboard little things and keys and little wooden like matches color as well. Then I thought about the present and the future in a sense of, again, technology and innovation. This is the magnetic earth structure. So I made it separately, tried to see where can I put it, just finally finished here, because it's something that is the everlasting property of the earth that we live with, so that stays forever like this in the past and in the future.